Hey homesteaders, I'm back with another tip to help you live better than all your friends who are still stuck in the rat race. Today, we're going to go through number 2 on your prepper survival kit, food. Let's go.
Welcome to Becky's Homestead.
In this video, I'm going to show you exactly what food I keep in my survival kit. But first, I have a question for you. When the power goes out, how long is the food in your refrigerator good for? How long is it still safe to eat? Do you know? The food in the refrigerator is only good for 4 hours if you keep the door shut. 4 hours is not that long, and then the food is questionable. If you think getting sick from dirty water is bad, food poisoning is even worse. You can die from food poisoning. The last thing you need when you're trying to survive is to make yourself sick because you're not prepared. The rule is, don't get hurt and don't get sick. So be prepared. That's the best way to handle all that. Here's a little tip. If you know the disaster is coming, throw all the stuff from your refrigerator into the freezer. That way, it will last longer. If your freezer is full, it can last 48 hours. If it's half full, about 24 hours. That's way longer than the refrigerator. The refrigerator is basically useless once the power goes out. The key is keeping the door closed. Don't keep opening it to see if it's still cold in there. Don't touch it. If your freezer is full of meat, it can last longer than 48 hours. But if your freezer is full of TV dinners and bread, you're probably lucky if it lasts 48 hours. It's worth the effort to get these few things together for your kit because in a true crisis, it will make a big difference. You have to make sure you keep your survival kit fresh, which means swapping out the food before it hits the expiration. Everything has an expiration date, even canned food. So I like to have food in my survival kit that I'm happy to eat when the expiration date comes. And you have to swap it out. It's not a problem. You're going to put it on the table and swap it out for the new stuff and eat the old stuff. Don't build your kit and bury it in the back of your closet. Then 3 years later when you need it, it's all expired. Keep it visible, keep it fresh. After a disaster, it's going to be stressful. So for my survival kit, I want food that's ready to grab and eat while I'm getting settled. Now, let me show you what food I keep in my kit. Organic honey. It really tastes good. It has nutrients in it. Also, if you get a cut, you can put organic honey on your cut and it can help prevent infections from developing. Okay, these little Quest bars, they're very small. I swear to God, I could almost shove that whole thing in my mouth in one bite if I was a pig, but definitely it's 2 big bites. They're very small, but they do have nutrition in them and they taste good. That's the key. You just, you know, you're in a survival, you know, situation. You want something that's gonna nourish you, not just taste good. And, you know, so that's good. But you want to get like a whole box of these. They sell them by the boxes. You've got to get a lot of these. We're just showing you one so you can see what it looks like. And the reason it's Quest is because it has nutrition in it. It's not just some cheap breakfast bar that's just pure sugar. You know, and yeah, Scott said Walmart sells these now. So good. Get them for a good price. Okay, and then coffee. Oh, we love this kind of coffee. I like to even drink this kind of coffee at home if I drink it. That's what I grew up drinking. It's good enough for me. I'm not that picky. Actually, this coffee tastes better. It smells good too. It tastes really good. Okay, it's in a glass jar, so you know nothing can get in there. What else? Oh, the powdered milk. They come in little bags like this. And the nice thing is, if you had to and you wanted it, no bugs to get in it, you could dump them all in a mason jar and then just have a little scoop in there and keep the bugs out, if that's what you're worried about. But they come in little envelopes like that, which is really good if you have little kids. You know, they might. And see, I want to show you this can of chocolate milk, condensed chocolate milk. You could even make chocolate milk for your kids if you wanted to spoil them. I only made chocolate milk for my kids when they were little for a special occasion. But you could just put a little bit, mix this up and just put a little bit of chocolate in it. They have smaller cans of this too. All right, next we talked about the sardines. Oh, I love sardines. Sardines are really healthy for you. They pack a lot of nutrition, protein, and fat into just a little tiny can. I'm gonna open one so you see though. You don't even need a can opener on some of this stuff. Pop top, canned beans. They're really cheap, but they're really nutritious. And you know, they just last until the expiration date, which is usually 1 year. The nice thing is when that time rolls around, like we're gonna make Southwestern egg rolls out of our beans. You can make something and then replenish your kit and just have a replenishing the kit meal of all the old stuff. So beans are really good. I love the beans. Also these raviolis, I don't think they're highly nutritious at all, but they're really good. And they're pretty filling. And then like a little treat, you can have some fruit, canned fruit works really well. And then I have canned milk as well as the powdered. That's always handy. And just go shopping, because this isn't enough food. I just want to give you an idea of what to put in your kit. You know, you're going to have to go shopping and make your kit the appropriate size for your family and how many people you have to feed. I want to show the, you know, make sure you have a can opener, even though, look, some are pop top like the fruit, but the beans aren't. So you're going to need a can opener. A lighter. I like these big boxes of matches. They're just easy to light if it's a little bit windy. There's tons of them in there. They're awesome. They even have green light now, I think it's called, where it's like, I don't know, eco-friendly matches, which is so weird, which I do have some of those. And then I just have a biscuit mix here. You can make different things if you can camp out and cook when the power's out. You could do like this with some water and dump a can of peaches on there, and you can make like a good dessert. You can use some of this stuff in your kit, and for bags, you can leave them in here, which will make them, and you could even put your matches in here to keep it so it doesn't get wet, and then put the, you know, put the lid on like that. Scott says, if the bug gets through this plastic thing and through the bag of food, it deserves it and it can have it. How big should my food supply be? Well, a minimum of 3 day supply, and longer if you live in an earthquake zone. Once you have your survival kit ready, you'll feel much better. While your neighbors are a mess waiting for somebody else to save them, you'll be happy you prepared ahead of time. Stay tuned for next week when I show you number 3 for your survival kit. If you like this video, please click the like button. It really helps me a lot. And I have a new video every week, so don't forget to push that subscribe button. Thanks to all my Patreon supporters. I couldn't do these videos without you. If you'd like to become a Patreon supporter and get special perks and rewards, the link is in the description below. Thanks for watching. Happy homesteading. Bye-bye.